What's up, y'all? This is Hussein Nasser from iGeometry, and today we're going to discuss JavaScript by example. So, what is that? What is JavaScript by example? So, these are a list of series of videos that we're going to do in this channel, and there will be around three or more series divided into levels. So the first level is level one, the second level, level two, and level three, where beginners, intermediate, and advanced, and perhaps more and more levels after that. So why did I do that? So the reason I started this series is because I believe that if you want to learn any skill, you have to do it in a practical manner. If you want to get fit, you go to the gym, you show up, and you do the work. If you want to learn a language, you speak to a native. You show up, you learn the skill. If you want to learn a programming language, although that's kind of controversial, and I don't believe you should learn a language, you have a goal to build something, and you use that language as just a tool that will allow you to reach that goal. All right. So by example series in general, and if you navigated the channel, this is my motto. I go by this ideology. Anything I want to learn, anything I want to teach is by example. I never teach different set of tools, right? I always have a goal. Hey, guys, we're going to build this application today. And we sit down and write that thing down. We write the application. We build the application from zero. We start from scratch. And we write every single line of code, right? I don't cut any of my videos. If we run into bugs, we sit down and fix those bugs. Because guess what? When you run and start building your own application, you're going to run into bugs. Because if people just show you how to go through the happy path, then you're not going to learn anything. Because, hey, this is a code and just go figure. That's the full code of how to build something, right? They give you the source code and you guarantee that this is the happy path and it works. But if you build it from scratch, yourself, you're gonna learn a lot. And personally, actually, when I was 15 years old, this is how I learned programming in general. I got this great book, right? So it's called Learning Visual Basic, I think Visual Basic 5 by John Socha. Great writer, really a great author. And he used a small, simple technique that I'm living by, even my life. I'm living by this technique. It's like he said, beginning of the book, we're gonna build a set of applications. And he sat down with us, like, I'm reading this book, and the first application was a clock, I think. And by the end of the chapter, I was writing this code one by one, right? And I have at the end of the book, of the chapter, I have a full work application that I built myself, right? So it feels really good. I run into trouble and I try to troubleshoot it and fix it myself. And then I added my own flavor to the application. I added my own touch. And that felt really good when I finished that. Right. So I believe personally that everyone should experience the same thing when they want to build application. If you don't know anything, if you're watching this series, you don't have to know anything. You don't have to know HTML. You don't have to know JavaScript. These are the two tools that we're going to use, but you don't have to know any of it. If you want to learn something, if you want a piece of thing, we're going to search and plug it in. But you have to have a goal, an application, building any application in real life. And right, if you want to build an application, You have to have that goal in life. And you just follow that steps. And if you need to learn something, you're going to learn it. Right? Because as there exists no programmer, no developer that knows everything. Right? So if you run into trouble, and I have 15 years of programming experience, and I've been software engineers into many firms, right? So if a programmer won't run into a problem, he search, how can I do this? But he has a goal at the end, right? I want to build this software. I want to build a software that does this, right? So he start working with it. He runs into trouble. He search, he research until he find a solution. He discusses with his colleagues. Is this the best thing way to do this? Maybe not. Maybe another colleague finds a better way, an optimal solution to do that. But that comes later. So that's the process of programming and software engineering in general, just very in a nutshell. But yeah, if you want to learn programming languages, if you want to learn JavaScript, if you want to learn HTML or JavaScript by example, right, in this case, we will do an example. We will actually build something while we learn. So that's the series, and we're going to stick with it. So that's just an introduction to this series, right? So I would like to think about this like a JavaScript by example series. So it looks like a book because I would think like there will be like units. Unit 1 is level 1, level 2 is unit 2. But it's structured like a book, but it's actually a video series. I don't know, is this a Vook maybe? A Vook? Yeah, I just made up this word, a Vook. I don't know. Yeah. Copyrighted, guys. I don't know. I'm being silly. So, yeah. If you're interested, stick around. We're going to learn programming or building an application the way it's supposed to be. All right, guys. Stick around.